Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. Declutter with me. Today I am decluttering the paper in my little office closet that is in our guest room. I recently did a declutter with me video decluttering the greeting cards that are in those two boxes. Also the gift bags that I ended up hanging up on these pants hangers, and then also gift tissue and gift wrap. After I declutter this paper, I am going to be decluttering the office supplies in this closet, so stay tuned for that. But for now, we are going to take care of this. These are two cardboard paper sorters that I got from Amazon. They're a good price. They are able to stack because, of course, the paper is not that heavy. They do have wooden ones, but you know, they're probably triple the price. Since they are in a closet, I thought the white cardboard would be fine, but if you'd like to have them out in the open, I think they still look decent. Now, all of the paper supplies that I have in my house are here in these paper sorters. I have the top ones, those are the legal size, and then all the construction paper, pastel paper, resume, even stuff that I use to laminate and to those sheet protectors that I use for my binders are all here, even the lined paper. So my kids or my family, when we need computer paper, printer paper, even lined ruler paper, we just have to go here. It's all here. It's not in my home office. It's not in their desks. It's not under the bed. It's nowhere else except here in this closet in my guest room where I have my office supplies. There are two reasons why I put all the paper here in these two paper sorters. One is so that we know if we are out, then we are out. If there's no printer paper in the printer or here in these organizers, then it's time to get some more or order more. The second reason is that I volunteer for a nonprofit, so sometimes I make a sign or I have to print up a volunteer form, or my kids have school projects and other projects that they have for extracurricular activities. So I know that I can go here and all the papers that I need to be creative are here, and of course all the supplies I have there too. So this is a one-stop shop, and that's what I love to do when I'm organizing. I've had this system, I think, I don't know if it's been 3 years maybe, and I showed this in a video of one of my three favorite organized spaces. If you want to see that, I'll put it in the iCards above. Okay, so I took everything down and you can kind of see what the cardboard sorter looks like there. This sorter holds more of the stationery type paper, and there's a large construction paper pad. Okay, this is what it looks like when you're looking into the sorter from above, and you can see it's pretty organized by color. I like to organize by the rainbow color, and then towards the bottom middle and on the right are the other papers like the lined ruler, laminate paper, printer paper. I'm going to keep the labels. This one says large paper and then legal size. I'm going to ahead and keep that label so that we remember to put those types of paper on top here. And then I'm going to keep this label that says letter size. It's very helpful to us when we are replenishing the printer paper or when we have to come here to take it out. We just know it's here. And if I get a large supply, it does fit in this one, that one, and this box. The other good thing about this is that it limits the space of how much paper I'm going to be getting. Paper is not construction paper like this. This is more stationary paper. It's gonna go into the second sorter. Red, pink, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, then I have for brown and black, or brown and black, and then like a cream. So basically I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 slots that I can fit all the different colored construction paper that I have in those. I decided not to label these like I have with the other labels I've used, like large paper, letter size, because once they're all in, you can tell which color it is. This yellow paper is cardstock paper, so my choice is either to put it in the sorter here with the other construction paper, or in the sorter there, which is pastel paper. Since this is a thicker paper or a heavier paper, I'm gonna go ahead and put it with the construction paper. Okay, this is also cardstock. I don't know if you can tell, these are slightly different green, so I'm gonna put, and it's a different size, so I'm gonna put this one in the lower one and the other one in the upper one. These two are different hues of blue, but I'm gonna keep them in the same slot. And then purple. And brown and black will go together. When I took everything out, I can see that there is a mix of cardstock and pastel paper here, and even one pad of stationery. And there are enough slots to do the rainbow colors and separate them for pastel, and then the other slots for cardstock, so I'm gonna do that. Now for the cardstock paper, this is for the red pink. So I went ahead and put the sorter back into the closet. This is what I ended up decluttering. It's not much, but it makes a difference. I'd say the number one tip is to take off the wrapper from the paper, because once you open up the wrapper just enough to take out the paper, you're never gonna be able to put the wrapper back so nice and neat. It's gonna look messy, so just taking off the wrapper makes the space look tidier. Then I put the large construction paper pad on top there where it says large paper. Here is the legal size paper, and I made it facing vertical towards the outside. I hope you enjoyed this video decluttering and tidying up this organization system for these types of papers. This system does work for me because the space is limited. All the paper is here in this closet in this organization system, and it's easy to maintain and tidy up. If you're new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. And until the next one, bye!